Hi, my name is Keith, and if you're watching this on YouTube, welcome to my channel formerly known as Wrath of Khan. I recently rebranded it to match the rest of my social media. Why? In short, I'm in the process of turning this channel into something more than it was. And I already had a logo, so there you go. Anyway, today I'm going to break down this rigging and animation test I did with Video Copilot's BB-8 CG model using their Element 3D plugin with Adobe After Effects. I'm in the pre-production stage of a narrative CG short starring BB-8, and I wanted to practice some character animation, which is something I've not done much of before. This isn't a detailed tutorial, but if you have any questions about specifics, please post in the comments, reply, send a message, and I'll do my best to answer. If you open Element 3D and import the BB-8 model, you'll see that it's already rigged using two auxiliary channels linked to the head and body. This is fine for something basic, but I wanted to have more control to allow for subtle movements that would make the animation more lifelike, more emotive. Here's what I mean. When BB-8 turns his head, I have the rest of his body move a little too. It's subtle, but it adds something. It's like when you move your own head. It's not just your head that moves, other parts of your body also move, even just slightly. It makes the difference between something completely mechanical and something alive. Even with big movements, more points of articulation make the animation more dynamic, like when BB-8's head flings forward a little further than the rest of his body when he stops. Here's how I rigged the model. First, I duplicated the model and made a hierarchy of folders that I could later assign to Element 3D's auxiliary channels. Within each instance of the model, I turned off those parts that weren't needed so not to have duplicates. For example, one instance was the body only, so the head and antenna were turned off. Next, I set up the auxiliary channels. Here you can see which folders and parts of the model were assigned to which auxiliary channel and how they could be moved individually or collectively. If you're unfamiliar with how auxiliary channels work in Element 3D, I'll post a link to a tutorial in the video description. I had to move some anchor points here and there to get the articulation I wanted. For example, I wanted to make sure BB-8's head could pitch forward, back, side to side along the body and not just rotate in one spot. The tool that pops out from underneath the accessory hatch was not part of the original model, and was created using Video Copilot's Motion Design 2-Pack. Once the auxiliary channels were assigned, I started animating. I also created a group null to move and rotate the entire model as needed. Seems like a lot of keyframes, right? But imagine if this was a human character. It can get complicated if you want it to look right. If you have any questions about why I animated a specific movement the way I did, leave a comment and I'll do my best to answer. Generally, I just felt it out and watched reference videos of BB-8 in motion. An important thing to remember when animating your character: learn to use the graph editor. You'll be amazed at what it will do for your animations, characters, motion graphics, or whatever. Don't just rely on default easy ease. The flamethrower effect was built using Red Giant's particular plugin and based on a tutorial by CG Visuals that I modified for my purposes. I'll post a link to the tutorial in the description. The flamethrower was built in a separate comp, then brought over to the main comp where I duplicated the layer with blend modes to taste. The flames cast light, of course, so I added a spotlight with a wiggle expression to cast on BB-8 and his surroundings. I have BB-8 rocking back and forth a little while spewing flames to simulate recoil. To make sure the particle emitter follows the movement of his flamethrower, I used Element 3D's Generate 3D Position utility to create a null layer, animated the null to match the end of BB-8's flamethrower, then parented the position of the emitter in the flamethrower comp to the position of the null in the main comp. And other than adding sound effects in Premiere, that's it. I hope you got something out of this breakdown workflow overview. Leave a comment below if you have any questions, or if you have any suggestions on how I could improve. I'm always learning. Also, please like and subscribe, making sure to click or tap on that bell to get notifications about future posts. If you're watching this on Instagram or Twitter, please like or retweet. See you next time.